Hello, I'm Todd, and I'm going to show you how to solve the system of linear equations using a process called partial pivoting. Computers are known for using this. They actually for a pivot, they select the one with the largest absolute value. But for now, we're just going to use ones with pivots. So you're just going to write the coefficients of each of these.
Can you put the broken lines, please? Because I get scared with. Okay. That's augmented matrix, right? Okay.
Yep. All right, so for the first pivot, we usually just pick. We have lots of ones to work with on this side. So we're just going to pick this one right off the bat. Now, because this is a 1, we don't have to worry about dividing, but normally if you picked any other number, we'd have to divide every other number in the same row by this number, but because it's 1, we don't have to worry about it. And because we selected this pivot, every column that was selected with this pivot, every other number other than the selected pivot goes to 0 automatically. So then we can just rewrite it as this. Now we're just going to take each number is going to correspond to, it's going to be basically this number subtract minus the product of the corresponding rows and columns. So I guess you could say, so this entry, specific entry, would be 1 minus the product of these two entries. So it would be 1 minus 1 minus 1. And then it'd be after that divided by the pivot you chose, however it's 1, so we don't have to worry about that. So we're just going to get a 0.
So basically what he's saying is if you want to change this 1, you look at this 1 and that 1, right? This is 1, that 1 minus 1 times 1 divided by 1. Okay?
Yeah, same thing for the bottom entry. We're just going to have the corresponding entries, so we have 2 and a 1, so we're going to go 1 minus product of those guys. So just going to get 1.
Any questions?
Same thing for this entry. Just going to have.
So it's negative 3, right?
Yep. This one's pretty much the same exact thing as this guy right here. So
you might want to write it so people can see. Good, okay.
Now as I said before, all these are all the same, so we already kept that, so we have that.
Maybe you can ask them what it is.
What's this last entry?
Zero.
You sure?
Yeah, 0.
Positive.
All right.
0.
Take your word for it.
Okay.
Okay. Now, for selecting a next pivot, note that you have to keep in mind what you chose for your last pivot. So, because we already worked with this column, this first column, we can no longer choose a pivot in this first column. And we can either choose a pivot from this column or this column. And also, so it's pretty much outs this column. So now we have to either work with this column or this column. So let's just work with the second one. And we got another 1 right here. However, keep in mind too, our pivot, we chose one from the first row. So depending on which column, which row you work with, you have to exclude it when you choose your next pivot. So we could easily choose this column, however, we can't choose this as a pivot since we already chose a pivot from the first row. So now we have to choose. So now the next best thing would be to choose either this guy or this guy. We'll just go with this pivot.
So notice Todd did not even bother to switch the rows, right? It's not important, really. You just want to produce a 1 in the next column.
Yeah.
Is that clear to everyone? Yeah, because all you want is like 1s in every column and 0s everywhere else, okay?
And this is just going to produce this only. So. Now everything's just going to go to zeros again.
So the pivot column will look like what?
0, 0, 1. Everything containing it.
Did you guys
Same
understand
thing.
That?
Now remember before how when you choose a pivot, you have to divide everything in the row containing that pivot by that number? Now we have a number other than 1. We have -1. So we're just going to divide everything by this pivot, but it's pretty trivial from here. Just 0, 1, 1.
Sorry.
And then you just get 0. And I didn't have to bother doing anything because remember that everything in this row, nothing happens to it except for the division part, and that's about it. So now we just need the other entries. This is everything right here is going to stay the same just because remember this it subtracts a product of its corresponding entries as we see here. And because we have a 0 here in this row, we don't have to worry about this whole entire column, it stays the same. So we're just going to end up with 0 and 1. Same thing here because let me see for here we have a 0 here, so this is going to stay the same. So this essentially would be like saying because we have a 0 here, it's just going to be the same. So it's going to be like saying this minus this product, so -0, and yeah, just over -1. That guy. So that's going to be that's just going to be 0. I mean -3. It's not going to change. Now, same thing for this. Well, not we can't say the same for this guy. We're gonna have 1 minus the product of 1, -1. Now, usually we were dividing by 1 the whole entire time because we have 1s, but now we have a -1 to work with, so negative. We're just gonna have, well, we'll have a negative anyway, so it'll be 0. So we have negative makes positive, so 1 yeah, 0.
So that will be a negative, so 0, okay.
Then, well, we're very fortunate in this case, because look at the entries in this pivot, in the pivot rows, pivot columns, the entries, 0, so it stays the same. Same thing for us, we have a 0 in one of the, as long as there's a 0 in the pivot column for that entry, we're fine. This does not change, so same thing here, it's just goes to 1. Okay, so far we've chosen a pivot for first row, first column, and then afterwards third row, second column. So now we're restricted to the last column, and we already worked with these two rows, so now we have no other choice but to work with this guy right here, so we have to make a pivot about this entry.
So you need that -3, right? That's
yeah.
Your pivot. Okay.
Everything just stays this now. Because we have -3 again, we have to divide everything by -3. Every other number in the same row by -3, but you know we have 0, so it just makes it pretty easy. So 0. And now we're just gonna go about doing the entries now. 0, it's not going to change as corresponding 0 entries, that's just going to be 0. Same thing with the 1. You notice usually when you work with these pivot columns, the 1s become 1-0-0s and 1-0-1s later on. They usually don't get changed later on by choosing other pivot columns.
Mm-hmm.
So usually you can usually just kind of go automatically, just write them out. I mean, of course, I just look at the entries just to kind of illustrate why it works, but usually you just go by the same thing as 0, so just 1. Now, if anything, the only changes, huh?
Sorry, and the reason for that is because of all the zeros, right, in the pivot row or column.
Yeah.
So you don't really have to worry.
So we only have to worry about these last two entries. So right here, we're just going to have a 0 minus 1 and 2. However, we have a pivot of negative case. That. The positives, we're going to have 0 plus 2 thirds.
Yeah, so it's 2 thirds.
Alright.
Right.
top row, well, we got a zero entry right off the bat, so that's pretty much confusing. So this basically implies x1 equals 1. X, we have our x sub 3 equals -2/3. And our x sub 2 equals 5.
That it? Any questions, guys? Thank you, Todd.